Hello everyone, welcome to a new Jurassic Park toy review. Okay, let's get started. Now let's get started on the detail. The detail of this dinosaur, this is the dinosaur from the first Jurassic Park. The detail is amazing on the head. Look, they even did the ridges and the bumps on here, and in the mouth. They even did a tongue. And they did detail on the teeth, even ridges on the teeth. They did the gums. That was very beautiful. And on here they did veins. The sculpt of this is amazing, how they did the detail. They even did bumps and scales up here, and then ridges like an elephant on it, just like it was in the movie. So the detail on this is amazing. On the legs, they did the Jurassic Park logo. This is 0.28, this model. They did paint the nails, the claws, nails. And the amazing detail on the feet. They even did scales on the ridges right here. This is plastic. Everything else is rubber. So they did like a mold. And then kind of used rubber inside the mold. And these then used full plastic. So this is solid. This is hollow. Now, I do not like the fact that it is hollow. Because when you're using it or something and it's all flimsy inside of it, the teeth and all that, that's amazing. It's amazing from there and on. It's just garbage. It's just, I don't like the inside, like the mouth. The mouth is amazing from there and then on. It's just awful. I don't think they should have done that. I think they should have at least blocked it off back there and then leave the rest hollow. But, and then when they were using the package, it literally was from here to here. And the rest of the tail, they bent the tail to make it fit in the package. And so when you take it out of the package, there's a big dent in the tail. The eyes are glass, and they do follow you. But it's kind of like an illusion. I thought that was very interesting. I thought that was cool. How they did that. And then, but even still, if you lift it up, you can see where they glued the eyes. You probably can't see from the camera. But, I mean, they could have done a little better on that. You know, like covering that up. And yes, you can move the arms. Little T-Rex arms. My biggest problem with this toy is the paint job. The paint job is just terrible. It looks like they got a tinsel and just spray painted it on the back. You know, like these stripes and stuff. It looks like it was spray painted. And then the green, this isn't even the real colors from the movie. And this is supposed to be the model of the T-Rex from the first Jurassic Park. And it did not have these stripes or this green. It was more like a really dark blue-ish, like a grayish blue color from the movie. And these are very interesting colors, but it is not the same colors from the movie. Back to the feet. They did, like I said, they did paint these claws, but they did not paint these claws. And that was not a good choice. I think they should have at least painted that or used a different plastic black. And I also think that they should have at least gone over the plastic with a black to bring out these creases, because it's amazing amount of detail, amazing artwork. But then they just kind of ruined it by leaving it like that. I think they should have gone over it with black to bring out all the detail of the feet, and I think that was a mistake. And they also didn't color in the
claws on the hands, on the arms.
Another problem I had with this toy, not the logo. I did like the logo, but they do cover up the creases to where they put them together. This one you cannot is a little harder to see, but when it comes around to the leg, you can see it better. But they did cover up that quite nicely. But right here, I mean, it looks like they just hot glued it on there. I think that they could have done better there. And you can see the difference between the rubber and the plastic. I think they could have done better on that. All in all, I did enjoy this toy. I thought it was amazing detail, and they did put a bit of effort into it, which they did pay attention to detail, which I really enjoy. I think they should have done better on the coloring, painting, I mean, and covering up where you can see the articulation, but this doesn't even move, where they attached each part. I think they could have worked harder to do that. Another problem I had with this toy was the packaging. The packaging was terrible. It bent the legs to where it doesn't stand straight, and they bent the tail. I hate that they bent the tail, because when I put it in my little on my shelf, it has a bent tail and it just looks terrible when with that. So I think this toy is a very good toy, all in all, mainly because of the detail. But I do believe that this is made for children to play with instead of putting on display, because if they had just paid more attention to the coloring of it and to how it really was in the movie, then it would be a perfect display item. So, hope you enjoyed this review. Stay tuned for more.